Hello, everyone. Back episode 102, Kane and Mint Streams. Welcome. Oh, so mate, I'm amazed this stream's happening at all. I'm not gonna lie. I had some issues. We'll talk about that in a second. But before we do, what is it? What are we playing today? This is Raid! ! Those who've read Terry Pratchett knows that any more than exclamation marks, shows signs of insanity. But anyway, that's by the by. Welcome to the stream. We are playing Raid, or Raid Over Moscow, as it was originally called. It changed the name when it was released in Europe for reasons. I'm playing on the Amstrad CPC 6128. Now, I did dither, and I almost played it on the Commodore 64. I could have done, but that's not the version I played as a child, well, teenager, really. So I thought, no, I could. It is a much better version, not going to lie. The original Commodore 64 version is sublime. But this is a good port. It's about 80%, 70% good. There's issues, but it's a good, solid port of a good, solid game. It's a multi-stage arcade game, which is quite tough, actually. I'm playing it, as I said, on my 6128. As you can see, there it is in its resplendence. I've actually had the keyboard replaced because a lot of the figures and numbers were faded away. The R's still a bit off, but the other one is even worse. But yeah, I've just replaced the keyboard. It looks pretty good, pretty good. The disk drive does work, but I'm not using it because I'm using the M4 card, which most Amstrad aficionados, including myself, use these days. The M4 card allows you to connect your Amstrad to the Wi-Fi and transfer files wirelessly. It's quite amazing. So, yeah, if you told me that, I'd have such a thing 30 years ago, and then I'd call you a lunatic. But, yeah, here we are. I'm using my Arcade R joystick. These are amazing. These are very similar from form factor to the beloved Competition Pro, only rather than the nasty, stiff sort of action that has, this has full Sanwar arcade components in it. So it's really, 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 really good. Really, really responsive. So yeah, this is a bright green one. It's the only one I had. And I actually wanted a bright green one. I was really happy with getting a bright green one because I'm not going to lose it, am I? Because it's bright green. So I'm going to go easy because I'm really rubbish at this game. There's something happened during the week. This weekend. I tried to get it working on the OSS2. OSSC. Sorry. This upscaler, awesome thing. It is fantastic. Unfortunately, it doesn't work with the Elgato capture. Doesn't work at all. Just get a black screen. I tried all sorts of things trying to get it to work. Wasn't having it. Just was not having it. I also tried the, so then I went to the C64, and then I went to use that, and that was a bad problem because I can't use that. That's upscaled for the C64 because it's composite. So I went to the retro kit thing, that didn't work either on the Elgato. So I think I might have to retire the Elgato. It's been a loyal servant, but I think it has to go. Because I can't have a device that doesn't work with my upscaler. So the basic the game is, I've got 7 minutes to stop the world from being blown up. So this is really hard. I'm probably going to screw this up. But anyway. Hey, first one out. Go get all these planes out of this hangar. Yeah, seriously, it's nasty. It's really hard. But anyway. It wouldn't open the door! I was pressing down to open the door, wasn't having it. Anyway. Not a lot of sound effects in this game. I've noticed. Oh, come on! This is worse than Docking Elite. It really is. Genuinely is worse. Anyway. Oh, I haven't had time to practice on the game because I had so many technical difficulties that I couldn't actually get enough time practicing. So I apologise for that. Normally, I spend a lot of time. There's a technique to this. There is. And I've got the first one out. So these are actually my lives, I'd like to point out. Just don't... this is embarrassing. Okay, I've got focus. It's a phrase I use a lot in these older games. So why am I playing this? Well, someone mentioned it on the Twitters. Oh, almost had it. I thought, I remember that game. I played it a lot on the Amstrad. I'll stream that. I'll stream that because I just get inspiration from people to stream stuff. I don't really, there's no rhyme or reason to what I'm streaming on Sunday evenings. It's just, bye. I got one plane to do this job. I've got one pilot. So now I've got to guide the aircraft. This flashing dot, you can just make it out there. So I've got to drop it down. It's the one. I've got one plane. This is embarrassing. But there it is. And you can just make out the missile flying across the surface of the Earth there, which is very terrifying. So I landed on the. So then it turns into a bit of Zaxxon, only not quite. So these are these tanks that shoot at you. You don't actually have to kill anything. Like, you know, you don't actually have to kill anything. You just have to get through to the end of this part. It's weird. So I don't have to shoot. I mean, you get points for shooting things. That's the only reward. To actually progress, you don't actually have to kill anything. So, anyway, it's a bit the scrolling's very juddery. So on the C64 version, it's butter smooth, but on the Amstrad, it's just, you know, brought to you amazing judder vision. But I did love playing this game as a kid. I really, really enjoyed it. I think it was really good, you know. I felt like they really tried with this because they didn't, you know. So this is the other part where you've got to line yourself up. There you go, I've got him. And then you've got to be the right height. And you sort of change colour to like a pinky colour. Here it is. Boom! And then, oh, there we go. Boom! There you go. And the last one. There it is. So that's blown up. And then you do that. And then I've got a whole bunch of new planes. And I've got to do this again. This time do a better job of it, Chris. Just do a better job. That's one. So I've got one out. Got one. Okay. Oh no. Gotta keep myself. Once I'm launched off the pad. Because this is basically a space hangar. Don't even know. On Call of Duty 2 years ago, it was all like in space. Ah, hit the side of the door. Never mind. Can do this. There is a technique to this, but I'll just clearly I haven't really nailed the technique. But there is an Atari 8-bit version of this as well. Which is very similar to the C64, but not quite. Not quite. Which is pretty much, you know, very common for Atari games, in that they're very similar to the C64, but not quite. It's also got a time limit as to when the door closes, so. Yay! Got two out! See the little dot there, the other dot? That's the other plane! Got two of them out! Oh boy! Right. I can do this. I believe in me. I can do the thing. Here we go. I've just got to land on the white city there. There we go. Or launch site. And then I sort of increase altitude and shoot missiles at the sky. Like that. You can shoot the buildings and stuff to extra points, but we're not here for points. We're here for progress, right? Because there's another two stages in this game. I want to show you. Hopefully I will get to do that. But yeah, there's another two stages in the game. But I'm not doing horrifically. I mean, then again, me destroying the planes is a bit rubbish. Yeah, it's not the great sort of greatest of things. So I am going to try and figure out a way of, because I don't like using the I don't like using the capture method I'm using now, because I get, there's an input lag, there's a very slight input lag, which is probably not helping me win at this game. Oh, come on. Destroyed the middle one. What about the rest of them? Okay. This is a bit weird. Okay, three planes. Come on. Game. Come on. Give me a little bit of a break, surely. No, it's not. Okay, I've only got one plane left to do, so let's try and get this right. That was close. That was too close. But I did like this game on when I originally played it back in the day. Like Kane, because I did stream Kane the other week, if you remember. And that was really entertaining. I loved playing that. I forgot how such a good game it was. Really is a good game. There you go, taking off. But this is very much a game of its time, like 1984. And this is, you know. But I think what I love about it is the level of complexity there is it's there. It's this, you know, it's it's really just really impressed for, you know, one of the earliest 8-bit games out there. And you can't knock it for, you know, trying. Almost got hit. I'm not sure about the collision detection in this bit. I think it's a bit ropey. Trying to get the level just right. There it is. So if you take out the middle one when you're playing on easy, I think, you know, you don't have to do the others. Might be wrong. And now this is, I'm now approaching Defense Center Landis. Or Landaz. Which I don't know what that means. But it's the last level. You know, just I haven't actually had to go to the hangar again. Which is a good thing. Because I'm not really good at that bit. Got to be said. I'm a bit rubbish. Liking the joystick though. I think the joystick is helping my ability to play this game. I'm fairly certain. If I used the like contemporary joystick of the time, I would have really struggled. But I am not. So thanks Arcade R for being awesome. They do sell them, actually. I might put a link up on the thing, maybe. Oh, he almost got me. Almost got me. Nasty. So now I've got to blow everything up. This is the weirdest bit of the game. So I've got to blow all the bits of... Which is not Russia. It's not the Kremlin at all. No! This is not the Kremlin. It looks remarkably like the Kremlin, but it isn't. There's no way of judging... I think I got shot. There you go. And the collision detection is very ropey. Here we go. Oh, I got shot and it's over. But I got pretty good score. I'll put my name in, why not? So last night I was playing Hell Point again, if you know that, on every Saturday evening. I'm working my way through Hell Point and made major progression. Very, very good. Enjoyed it immensely. Yeah, if you're about... Hey, RJ! Target Rectangle. Thank you for joining us in this fine evening. So yeah, I made 20 minutes of so far and I made pretty good progress. Sticking to easy. I'm rubbish at this game. Not a lot of sound effects or music or anything. Not in any version. That includes the C64, which is a bit weird. I hate this bit. I do. I appreciate for what it is. But, you know, I just can't get on with it. I'm sure there's a technique to it, so... But that's not it. Not square. I'm not square, no. I'm not square on. What doesn't make a lot of sense is why does the craft start like that? I mean, I thought I had a technique then. It is possible to score 0 points, by the way, in this game. Raid is definitely not on rails. No, it is not on rails. This game is not on rails. No. Yeah. There's only got one life left now, one play left. It was absolutely dead on as well. See, I don't like playing games badly. I genuinely don't. And I've been playing a lot of games recently, lots of different games. I mean, I play the Xbox Series X and its ability to switch games just randomly. Like, 1 minute you're playing a platform, next minute you're in a first-person shooter, next minute it's a driving game. I mean, what are you supposed to do with your brain at that point? You know, it's a switch and switch and switch. This, you know, it's just awesome, this whole fast sort of switcher thing. It's great. It's also terrifying. Your brain just can't handle it. And that's my excuse for my inability to play this game. It's a poor one, but I'm sticking with it. Now, a question some may ask at this point, you know, is this worthy of an update? You know, like a revised version. And my honest answer to that question is no. There's a lot. I mean, if you want a really good shooter, Gradius 5, MK streams a lot. It's awesome. That's a real. This is of its time. It's great, but of its time. And. I think it's, you know, it's worthy of note. I do enjoy it. It's a good game. Genuinely is a good game. It's entertaining. It's good. It's not great. It's not, you know. Hard to know whether those bullets are going to hit me or not. Boom.
Oh.
Oh, come on, game. There you go. So I think you shoot those silos, you shoot all those silos, you get more planes. So that's a good thing for me to do. I should do that. And here we are with the hangar again. No. Oh, I thought I got a method. I'll do this. I can do this. I'm aware of the clock. You know this clock? I've got 4 minutes. So I've actually got 4 minutes to get to the base. Oh, just. Into the depths of space. I'm not going to speak too soon, but I think I may have acquired a technique. I spoke too soon. Never mind. Never mind. I can do this. Never mind. Three planes. That'll do. That'll do. Not ideal, but it'll do. Got 2 minutes. Too long in the hangar. Far too long in the hangar. And what I like to do is show you the fifth stage, because that's kind of cool. And if I... Oh, no. There you go. Yeah, it's a bit annoying that the sound effects are so terribly sparse. You know, it would be nice if it was a little bit more, but... No, stay up in the air. I like the sort of the colours though. Very colourful game. They used a little bit more of a... They sort of exploited the Amstrad palette a bit with this game. And it was one of the earlier releases, so... I've got 23 seconds, maybe. I just realised I've got 21 seconds to Oh well. Dear. Millions of people are dead due to my incompetence. That's terrible. Go blow up. No, this is all wrong. It's all wrong. There is a technique that I thought I had. Just basically spin the plane round, Chris, and then there you go. Pity's sake. Oh well, game over. Not the greatest score in the world. Didn't even get on the scoreboard. Not surprised. Not surprised. Fine. Fine. Let's try this again. Ah, oh, I thought I was going to slip it underneath the door. But no, not quite. Just. I'm dicing with death here, I'm fully aware. No, I couldn't get it. I mean, I was I'm sure I've got to get better at this. Nope. Looks like I'm not going to get better at this. But it's definitely a game of its time. Appreciate the challenge. you know, that's fine. I don't have a problem with that. Oh, come on. Come on. That was all right, wasn't it? Okay. Well, that's the best, most chips I've ever had. Lies I've ever had. That's got, give me that. But I've used 3 minutes up doing it. Let it gently float down onto the site. So yeah, this is all really visually impressive to me at the back of the day. But wow, this looks amazing. And it pretty much was. Like I said, this game is 36 years old, you know. Give it a break. like I said, I don't like the scrolling here though. They could have done a better job, but they didn't. I mean, the techniques for scrolling in the Amstrad were not as advanced, because there was no hardware scrolling on the Amstrad, unlike the C64. So it can do the smooth scrolling that the C64 was actually quite famous for, really. What? That's the first time I've actually got hit by anything. Not flying that. Nope. Looks like the stream's a bit stuttering. There it goes. Suddenly thought, like, am I recording? Yes, I am. I think I crashed into that water tower. Any certain I crashed into the water tower. So, it's best to avoid that. Is it a water tower, or is it a, you know, a crow's nest? Like, sort of, lookout post, probably one of those. That's a bunker there. That definitely looks like a bunker. And then we got this. Take down the helicopter. Go past this lot. And then we got this phase. So I'm going to get some more planes. Because I'm greedy like that. I'm lined up. Here we go. Bang. I'll get the last one. Is that it? Why not? I'm sure the more you play this game, you get like used to whereabouts each one is, and you can do it easier. But okay, so I've got a lot more planes back, so I've got more time to practice to get out of the bloody hangar. I love this bit. Favorite bit. Nice. Actually, it wasn't. That was quite clumsy. But it got out. I got one out. And another one. It's, honestly, this is way harder than it looks. Thank you. I think I almost hit the top roof of the door there. But I did it. Oops, too much. I was hoping to get a clean sheet then, but not to be. Right. So next week, what are we going to play next week? I've got some ideas. But it will be something. Of course it will. It will be something. Yeah. Me sort of thinking about what to play next week. It will be something modern, something recent. Oh, you know what I could do? Yes. I know exactly the game I'm going to play next week. Oh, no. No, that was the cheap death. Cheap death. I was landing back on the deck. Come on, game! Never mind. I got a fair few. Again, not bad. I'm going to take note of the time this time. I've got 5 minutes and 45 seconds. Gently. Come on, take your time. You've got all the time in the world. I've got 4 planes there, I think. I've got 5 planes there. I had to take a drink, didn't I? Welcome to video games from this period, because there was no pause. At least I don't. There was sometimes a pause button, but I don't think there's a pause button for this. But I had to take a drink. I've been talking a lot. I'm not sure if it's possible to fly under that bridge. I'm not going to try either. I have to say, this is the least challenging bit. And it is a little... I mean, there's no purpose to it other than point scoring in a sense of progression. Like, oh, you now got to fly to the base and destroy the enemy helicopter. And, you know, it's all, you know, adds drama, I guess. So I'm going to... So I've got a full rack of planes now. That's good. I'll take another drink now. Right. Enemy launch detected. Another one. Here we are again. With my inept attempts at leaving the hangar. You got time when you open that door. You got to press. Yeah, it's not I would like to actually have a go at this C64 version of this. It won't actually open the door unless you're at a certain altitude. It's really clever. It's clever. For its time. I keep on saying for its time, but honestly it is very clever. Ah! I'm sure it's very frustrating to watch, but trust me, it is no mean feat to achieve this. To practice. I'm sure if I practice this, I will get. I was planning to play this a lot more today than I've ended up doing, but unfortunately, due to technical issues, as I said earlier, I couldn't spend the time I wanted with the game. So I'm really annoyed at myself, but it's a bleeding miracle we got it streaming at all, quite frankly. Straight into the top of the roof. Problem with the stream there. I can't really. Can I pause again? No, there's no pause. Unless it's like. Oh god. What have I done? I pressed return to quit. That's the worst thing. I just noticed the stream's died, so I've got to look into that. Sorry for the archive viewers, but hey, you know, I did reasonably well then. So let's do a reload on that. As far as I know, I'm still streaming. Unless it's all red. Yeah, all green on that side, so. Let's do a reload and see what's going on. There it is. Right. We should continue. I mean, we'll just carry on playing, But Bartlow's death machine, I think that's what it's called. Damn it. That's what I'm going to stream next week. It's a really, really cool game. I really like it. And I had I interviewed the developers not too long ago on the Sausage Factory. So I really am not getting on with this bit. I'm just trying to develop a technique, but was that a valid technique? I don't know. It's the same position. It's the same thing over and over again. It doesn't vary. But for some reason, I just. These little gauges on the right-hand side are very useful. Nah, it's just swinging too far. The thruster's going too far. Never mind. I knew this would be a problem with this game when I thought of like streaming. Yeah, it'd be a good idea, Chris, but you know, this part is a bit of a bum thing. I'm not a fan. That was a bit precarious. I've got it. That means, you know. A pilot, I am not, clearly. Right. To get better at that, if I'm gonna get there, make it. I don't think, yeah, we've got 9 minutes. We're not gonna get to see the final stage. I'm very sad about that, but you did see a lot of the game. There is one final stage you have to blow up a robot with a bouncing disc. Don't. Oh, there's a dancing soldier in it as well. So I was a little bit disappointed that you're not gonna see the dancing soldier, but never mind. Never mind. Like I said, I really wanted to spend a lot of time with this game so I could get better at it before the stream, which is what I normally do. But unfortunately, like I said, I had some major technical issues with the game, with the streaming on the devices and stuff, because I've had to use a really bog standard upscaler to get it to talk to the Elgato. And that's really frustrating, so I'm going to have to do some research to find out what's going on and what other things I need to do to make it work. So I'll be doing that, try to, because I don't want to spend loads of more money on things that I'd rather not. It's been an expensive month as it is, with two new consoles arriving. I'm very happy with them both, but yeah, it's not been cheap. Liking the stereo sound of the Amstrad, very nice. I'm just debating whether I should just go straight for it or what. How did I miss? What? Well, I'm going to have to blow this one up, aren't I? Just realise I've got no time again. And German, the launch site has been destroyed. Yeah, good. So, huh? Crashed then, I think. That's weird. Interesting. I think it just crashed then. I think it did. Let's just carry on. Let's just do this thing. Oh, look, it's got a bit squiffy. Look, oh, yes. Yeah, that's not good. Look at that. Look, that's gone all squiffy. Yeah. Oh, dear. I think the weather code is going on in the... It's not well. As you can tell, it's like, oh dear. So try another go, so try again, or is it going to be? Yeah, all that, it's all corrupt. Oh dear. Oh look, we get a light. It's disco time now. Yeah, it's not well. what a way to end the stream. But I think we will end it there. A little bit early, but clearly the version I dragged from the internet is not really happy, or maybe the 6128. I don't know. Lots of variables. Be that as it may, thank you very much for watching this video, stream, whatever. It's been great. I really enjoyed it, actually, even despite the hangar thing. Bartlow's Dread Machine. That's what it's called. Bartlow's Dread Machine is the stream next week. It's a twin-stick shooter on rails. It's really good, though. It's really interesting. Very, very well put together. Beautiful game. And I will be streaming that next week. So until then, thank you very much for watching. Bye!